Welcome to our online class. This is Ma'am Teresa Tubal. Join me to enjoy mathematics. Let us explore about polynomial equation. So what is polynomial equation? When a polynomial expression p of x is set to 0. So as you can see, this is polynomial equation and then equal to 0. So kung may equal to 0, that is polynomial equation. Next, what could be the standard form of the polynomial equation? When the terms are arranged from highest exponent to the lowest exponent and then equal to 0. Let us define the leading term, the leading coefficient, and degree. So what is the leading term? The leading term is the highest exponent. So it means 5x squared is the leading term. How about the leading coefficient? The leading coefficient is the numerical coefficient of the leading term. If the leading term is 5x squared, it means the numerical coefficient is 5. So that is the leading coefficient. So how about the degree? The degree is the highest exponent in the expression. So the highest exponent in this expression is 2. So let us identify the leading term, the leading coefficient, and the degree of the following polynomial equation. Number 1, 3x to the 4th plus 5x plus 19 is equal to 0. So hanapin yung highest exponent. So the leading term is 3x to the 4th. The leading coefficient is the numerical coefficient of the leading term. So that is equal to 3. And then the degree, the highest degree, is equal to 4. Next, let us proceed to number 2. 2x minus 15 is equal to 0. Again, the leading term is equal to 2x. The leading coefficient is the numerical coefficient of 2x, so that is equal to 2. And then the degree, correct, that is equal to 1. Because the highest degree of x is equal to 1. So let us proceed to number 3. X plus 5 times x minus 2 times x plus 7 is equal to 0. What is the leading term? Correct, that is x cubed, because x times x is x squared times x is x cubed. Next, what could be the value of the leading coefficient? So the leading coefficient is the numerical coefficient of x cubed, so that is equal to 1. Next, how about the degree? So the degree is equal to 3. Next, fourth example, 4 minus 3x to the 4th plus 3x to the 10 minus 3x is equal to 0. So hanapin yung pinakamataas na exponent. So, the leading term is 3x to the 10. So, the leading coefficient is the numerical coefficient of 3x to the 10. So, that is equal to 3. So, the degree is equal to 10. Last example, 8 plus 2x minus 3x to the 4th plus 5x to the 7 is equal to 0. Hanapin yung mataas exponent. So, the leading term is 5x to the 7. So, the leading coefficient is the numerical coefficient of the leading term, so that is equal to 5. And then the degree is equal to 7. So, let us determine the degree and the roots of the given polynomials. Determine the degree and roots of the given polynomial equation x minus 5 times x plus 2 times x minus 2 is equal to 0. So let us identify the degree of the polynomial. So the degree of the polynomial is equal to 3 because x times x is x squared times x is x cubed. So we have 3 maximum roots. So let us identify the 3 maximum roots. So paghiwa-hiwalay natin siya using zero product rule. X minus 5 is equal to 0, so it means x, change the sign of negative 5 going to right, so that is positive 5. Next, x plus 2 is equal to 0, solve for x, x is equal to negative 2. And then the last one, x minus 2 is equal to 0, let us solve for x, x is equal to positive 2. So it means the roots are positive 5, negative 2, and positive 2. How about number 2? In the quantity x minus 3 cubed times x plus 7, what is the degree of the polynomial? Correct. The answer is equal to 4x cubed times x is x to the 4th. So it means we have 4 maximum roots. How to identify the different roots? So again, x minus 3 raised to the 3rd power. So tatlong beses natin siya isosolve. So the first, x minus 3 is equal to 0. So it means x is equal to positive 3. Again, x minus 3 is equal to 0. X, change the sign of negative 3 going to right, that is positive 3. And then the third time, x minus 3 is equal to 0, so x is equal to positive 3. So, ang exponent ay 3, kaya tatlong beses sinulat. Okay, next. X plus 7 is equal to 0, solve for x. X is equal to negative 7. So, it means the roots are 3, 3, 3, and negative 7. So, the final answer is 3. Multiplicity of 3, kasi tatlo yung 3, and then negative 7. How about number 3? In the given x plus 3 times x plus 5 times x squared minus 5x plus 4. So let us get the factor of x squared minus 5x plus 4. So the product must be positive 4, and then the sum should be negative 5. Think of factor, if you multiply, the product is 4 and then the sum is negative 5. Correct. That is negative 4 and negative 1. So the factors are x minus 1 times x minus 4. And then we need to copy x plus 3 and then x plus 5. What could be the degree of this given polynomial equation? Correct. The answer is equal to 4. Kung bibilangin natin 1, 2, 3, 4, or x times x times x times x is x to the 4th. It means the highest degree is equal to 4. Next, let us identify the different roots. So the first is x plus 3 is equal to 0. Solve for x. X is equal to negative 3. Second one, x plus 5 is equal to 0. So x is equal to negative 5. Positive 5 going to right, that is negative 5. Next, x minus 1 is equal to 0. Solve for x. X is equal to positive 1. Negative 1 going to right, change the sign. Next, x minus 4 is equal to 0. So x is equal to negative 4 going to right, that becomes positive 4. So the roots are negative 3, negative 5, 1, and positive 4. So let us apply what you have learned about polynomial equation. Structure. Determine the roots of the polynomial equation. Question number 1. Let us determine the roots of the polynomial equation x minus 3 times x plus 7 times x minus 2 times x minus 11 is equal to 0. What do you think is the answer? Correct. The answer is 3, negative 7, 2, and 11. How about number 2? Let us determine the roots of x minus 5 times x plus 7 times the quantity x plus 8 raised to the 4th power. What is the answer? Correct. The answer is 5, negative 7, negative 8, multiplicity of 4 because the exponent is 4. How about number 3? X times x minus 1 times x plus 7 times x squared plus 6x minus 7. What is the answer? Correct. The answer is 0, positive 1, negative 7, and then 7 and negative 1. I hope you learned something new about the polynomial equation. Enjoy learning mathematics. I'm Teresa Tubal. Thank you so much.